Welcome back, everyone. Here's what you need to know to start your day. New overnight, CAL FIRE crews responded to a trailer fire in Cottonwood. It started around 5:45 Wednesday night on Reed Avenue. CAL FIRE reps say everyone made it out of the trailer. One person had minor injuries but was not taken to the hospital. Action News Now is working to find out more information on the damage to that structure. If you are planning to hit the roads and head home today, you might want to hold off for another day if possible. AAA says it could be the busiest day of the year today and that you can expect traffic delays to almost double your trip time. Six new laws impacting drivers will go into effect next year. One new law will allow bicyclists to travel straight through turn lanes, either right or left at intersections. If you're caught using a handheld device while driving, you'll get a ticket and a point on your record. Several new laws will place more limits on how police can use deadly force. A day in the outdoors turned deadly for a hiker killed by a falling tree in California's Muir Woods. It happened Christmas Eve. Park reps say five trees toppled onto the trail, with one of them crashing directly onto a group of hikers, killing a 29-year-old man and injuring a woman. Another man escaped unharmed. Park rangers say this type of incident is rare, but add winter storms this past week may be partly to blame. Law enforcement is searching for an Oregon woman missing since Sunday. 20-year-old Allison Watterson was last seen hiking. Family, friends and volunteers spent Christmas Day searching the area that she was last seen. Deputies are asking anyone with information to contact the Washington County Sheriff's Office. A Republican senator is breaking ranks with her party over impeachment. Senator Lisa Murkowski of Alaska said she was, quote, disturbed by Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell's stance for total coordination with the White House. Senator Murkowski says she has not decided how she will vote if the articles of impeachment come to the Senate. Christmas arrived with no apparent gift from North Korea. The regime had threatened to deliver something if the United States failed to restart stalled denuclearization talks. The U.S. wasn't taking any chances, reportedly flying surveillance planes over the Korean Peninsula. The regime also threatened to take unspecified action if U.S. sanctions are not eased by the end of the year.